So what is the custom source for curve shape in Anim Curves, and how do you use it? Let's take a look. What's up, everybody? If you've seen my other videos on Anim Curves, you know we've covered almost every other setting in Anim Curves except for the custom source for curve shape, and that's what we're going to cover today. So if you want to catch up on any of those other videos, you can use the links in the video description or this link to get to that playlist. So let's jump right into Fusion and get to it. So I have a basic Fusion composition that's 3 seconds long, and all I have is a background and the DaVinci Resolve logo. And then let's just do a basic animation on the size. I won't do anything complicated. We're not gonna worry about position or anything like that. We're just gonna animate it in based on size and then animate it out based on size. So why would we even wanna use custom source for curve shape in Anim Curves? You can do almost anything you want in Anim Curves without using any keyframes. And that's one of the great things about using the Anim Curves is that you don't have to use keyframes and it does adapt everything automatically. But there is a drawback to that, and I can illustrate that here. If I go back to the timeline and I create a copy of this animation that we just created, and let's say I just stretch this out to more like 10 seconds or somewhere in that vicinity, I'm going to disable our first Fusion composition. And if we play through this lengthened Fusion composition, the animation timing has been stretched out proportionately based on the changes in length of that Fusion composition. We can convert this to use the custom source for curve shape and set up a couple of keyframes and use a keyframe stretcher, and it will maintain the exact timing of that animation, but still give us all the benefits of using Anim Curves and the different curve shapes available and those other settings that make animating so easy. So let's convert this over and then we'll take a look at those results. Let me pause just a second and say thanks so much for taking the time to watch this video. My name is Ron, and my goal is to provide you with tips, techniques, tools, and assets all specific to DaVinci Resolve to help you with video editing and motion graphics. So if you want that kind of content, please be sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell, and enable all notifications so you'll be alerted whenever I post a new video. Back to the custom source. As we can see, we have a 1 second intro, static for a second, and then a 1 second outro animation. And I'm gonna set the source to custom. And now we just have to set the input keyframes so that the Anim Curves knows when to start executing the animation and when to stop executing the animation. So I'm going to start at the beginning of the composition, and I'm gonna set a keyframe for input at 0. To mimic what we created before, I'm gonna go 1 second in, which is going to be 24 frames. And then I'm going to set another keyframe on input and set it to 1.0. And now because we've gone to the custom source, I do need to change the time scale. I had that set to 3 based on the other curve source. For simplicity, I'm gonna set this to 1. And based on these settings, this should now mimic everything that I had set up originally. So let's play through the beginning of this and see how that intro animation looks. And then our outro animation is unchanged at this point. So you can see that matches exactly what was set up based on using duration as the source and the other settings that we had set up. So now I'll convert the outro animation to use the custom source as well. I'll go to the outro transform frame 48, set the source to custom, and at frame 48, I will set a keyframe for input at 0. Go to the end of the composition. I'll set a keyframe on the last frame, setting the input to 1.0, and then I do need to reset the time offset to 0 since we have basically overridden the time offset settings by the input keyframes. We can now see that we have recreated the Anim Curves using the custom source and a couple of keyframes. So if we leave it just like it is and we extend the duration of that composition, the timing of the intro and outro animations remain the same, but the outro animation will not follow the end of that composition as it's stretched out. And if we just drag this out to the length of the other composition that we played around with, and we go to the beginning of this composition and hit play, we see our intro animation happens, but then our outro animation also happens by the end of the 3rd second, and then it's completely gone for the rest of that composition. I'll add a keyframe stretcher, and we'll leave the source start set to 0 because our animation does start at the very first frame of the composition. but I will change our source end to 71 because if we look at the outro animation, our last keyframe is at frame 71. And then if we check the intro animation, our last animation keyframe is on frame 24. And for the outro animation, our first keyframe is on frame 48. So if we go back to the keyframe stretcher, we want to set our stretch start to 24, which in this case it's set to by default, but we need our stretch end to end at frame 48. So now if we just go back to the timeline to play through this and go to the beginning, we can see that our intro animation executes in the first second, and then everything stays static for 8 seconds, and then the outro animation will kick in on the last second of that composition. And if we scale this down closer to 5 seconds and play through that, intro animation executes over the first second, it stays static for a few seconds, and then the outro animation executes. By setting just 2 keyframes, we still have all of the benefits of the Anim Curves and all the settings that it gives us and all the controls that it gives us and all of the easy animation benefits of using Anim Curves, but we still get to maintain that exact timing for the animation even if we change the duration of that clip. You can use values other than 0 and 1 for the input keyframes. And I'll give you a little illustration here just to show you how that can behave differently. So I'll go back into Fusion, and then I'll just look at the intro animation, for example, and I'll go to the Anim Curves modifier. At the beginning of our composition, the input is set to 0 with a keyframe. And then at frame 24, I have the input set to 1.0. So what would happen if we change this to 2.0, for example? It's effectively the same as setting our time scale to 2.0. So I'm gonna leave the time scale at 1, but we have our input set to 2.0. And if we go back to the beginning of this composition and hit play, we can see that the animation is executing twice as fast as normal. So we'll go back to the second keyframe for the intro animation. We'll leave the input at 2.0, but I'll change the time scale to 0.5. And those two will interplay. So an input of 2.0 multiplied times a time scale of 0.5 gives us 1.0. Now the animation would execute back at normal speed as we had it set up before. And you can see now that that is recalibrated based on changing the input value higher than 2.0 with a time scale of lower than 1.0 so that they offset one another. So what is the benefit of doing that? Well, it really comes down to whatever works best for you. As I said before, I find it simplest just to use a range of 0 to 1 for the input values, and then I can adjust the timing and timing offset as I need to control that animation. You have lots of flexibility, as with all the other settings in Anim Curves, to do just about whatever you want. It's just a matter of learning how those different settings work and how you can apply those to your project to get the results that you're looking for. So which curve shapes have you used in your Anim Curves? Have you tried the custom source, and how did that go? And did you learn any other tips or techniques along the way? Drop those in the comments and let me know. I'd love to hear from you, and I'm sure the rest of the viewers would appreciate that input as well. And if you have any requests for future content, please drop that in the comments also. And if you found this video informational or useful, please do hit that thumbs up button to share it with your friends. That really helps the channel out a lot, and it means a lot to me as well. And it shows YouTube that you appreciate the content. And if you're new here, please do consider subscribing, hitting that notification bell, and enabling all notifications so you'll be alerted whenever I post a new video. Thanks so much for watching. Have fun in Fusion. I'll see you next time.